This is how to find K given an initial concentration and one final amount. 4.25 moles sulfur trioxide are placed in a 15.5 liter flask and allowed to equilibrate at some temperature. At equilibrium, 1.08 moles SO3 remain. Make a reaction table and determine Kc. Use units of moles for the reaction table. Okay, very well. We have our initial row, and right before the reaction starts, we have 4.25 moles of sulfur trioxide and no product. Delta is what we're going to figure out, and we are given a final concentration at equilibrium, and we're told that 1.08 moles of SO3 remain. Okay, this is what I call backing out the delta row. If I know the initial amount and I know the final amount of SO3, then I can get delta. So that would be 4.25 minus 1.08. So I know this value has to be minus 3.17. Now, the delta row is always locked in stoichiometry, so if this is minus 3.17, then SO2 has to be plus 3.17, because I'm making it. I know this because the coefficients are the same, 2 to 2. On the other hand, the oxygen coefficient is a 1, so I know that it has to be 1/2 of 3.17, or plus 1.585. So, notice the stoichiometry of my reaction is 2 to 2 to 1. The stoichiometry of my delta row is 2 to 2 to 1. All right, well, now I can just do the bookkeeping here, and my SO2 concentration is 3.17 moles. And my O2 concentration is 1.585 moles. Alright, my reaction table's done. Now it's time to get my equilibrium constant. The expression is SO2 squared O2 to the first power over SO3 squared. Now, I am getting Kc, so I need to put that in concentration units. Concentration is, of course, moles over liters, so I will write this as SO2 being 3.17 over 15.5 squared. O2 is 1.585 over 15.5 to the first power. And my denominator is 1.08 over 15.5 squared. I will put that all into my calculator. And the value of my equilibrium constant comes out to be 8.81 times 10 to the minus 1. And that would be in units of molar. And that's all there is to that.